Hey, do you hate doing the same stuff twice? Well, I've got a solution for this. Hey guys! Today I'm going to present you another Python automation module, which is called Pyautogui. It can be used for automating keyboard inputs, mouse movements and mouse actions. I created two different projects for you, which I uploaded on my GitHub website. You find the link to my GitHub in the description box. Let's first have a quick look at my GitHub page. So when you go to the link, you need these two projects, Form Filler and Python HTML Flask. You can download my Python repository by clicking on code and then on download zip. Next, we are going to jump to Pycharm. If you don't have Pycharm yet, you can download it on the IntelliJ website, which I will also link in the description box. First, you need to open the Python HTML Flask project. You don't need to understand the code from this project. We only use it to start up our simple website with some form fields, which we can fill out with Pyautogui. To be able to run this project, you will need to install Flask, which is a Python micro framework. For this, open up your terminal and then enter pip install flask. To run the project, click on the server.py file and then click on run at the top here. Now our website is running at this address. Now in a new window, we need to open our other project called FormFiller. The FormFiller.py file will automatically start the website we are running right now. But before we start, we need to install a few more modules. So let's jump to the Pyautogui website, which I will also link in the description box. Depending on which operating system you use, you need to follow different instructions. So we have different ones for Windows, macOS, and Linux. I already installed this. So yeah, have a look at the website and pick what you need. Next, we need to install Selenium because we use it to automatically start our website. So you just need to type pip install Selenium. Of course, you can use Pyautogui on its own. I'm only using Selenium to automatically starting my website. And the next thing we need is GeckoDriver for Firefox. You find it on GitHub. I will also link it. And then when you scroll down here, you can see the different installing packages for Linux, macOS, and Windows. In this tutorial, I will only show you a tiny part of the Pyautogui module. If you want to see all the functions, go on the Pyautogui website, which I will also link in the description box. Now let's run the formfiller.py file to have a look at the website first. So for this, click on run. Okay, and now we need to check what we want to do. So first we need to click here, then we want to write something here, then we want to go to the next field, which we can do with tab, and then we want to write something here, and to go to the dropdown, we need to click tab again, and then we want to choose cat, which we can do with the down key, and then to go to the yes and no menu, we press tab again, and to choose yes, you can press space, and then press tab to go to send. And then we just need to click with the mouse here on the send button. So we have two graphical user interface elements for which we need the X and Y coordinates. The first one is the first name field and the second one is the send button. I created a different program for this. So let's minimize it. It's the mousenow.py file. First, we sleep for 5 seconds so that we have time to move the mouse at the position we want. And then in line 7, we are printing the actual position. So let's choose mouse now here and then click on run. And then open your website and move the mouse to the first name field and wait a few seconds. Then go back to our window here and then you can see it printed X604 and y351. Let's go back to the formfiller.py file and fill in the coordinates here, 604 and 351. Just for completeness, I also want to show you line 8. This is a function from Selenium. Because we are using a website, we can also find the element by its ID. And the ID of the field is fname, and then you can click on it. If you want to know how you can find IDs from website elements with Selenium, I already created a tutorial about Selenium, which I will put in a card at the top and also link in the description box. Okay, now I'm also going to fetch the X and Y coordinates for the send button. So I'm going to run mouse now again and open the website. Position my mouse on the send button and wait a few seconds. And then we are going to fill in the coordinates again. And now let's uncomment the rest. And again in line 15, I also added a possibility to fetch the send element with Selenium, just for your information. Okay, now we have the X and Y coordinates filled in. And in line 9, we are gonna type Hermione in the first field and then press tab. Then we are going to fill Granger as last name and press tab again. And next in the drop-down menu, we're gonna go down one time, then we're gonna press tab again. And for choosing yes, we are going to press space. Then we are going to press tab again. And after this, we are going to click on the send button, but for now we're gonna run it like this. And as you can see, it filled in everything. And now we also want to click on the send button, close the window again, and uncomment line 14. And then run it again. You can also press Shift and F10 instead of clicking on run. And as you can see, it now says your data has been sent successfully. We look forward to seeing you in September. If you enjoyed this video, I'm always happy about a thumbs up. Also, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching and have a nice day. Bye!